guys, it's Grant with Freedom Van Gogh, and today we're gonna talk about what you use to get around when you're at your camp spot or at your middle to final destination. I do a lot of travel inside cities for events. So for me, being able to park the van somewhere wherever I'm gonna end up for the night and travel around in various areas to get food, to get sustenance, to get supplies, whatever I need is absolutely imperative. And this is kind of the evolution you see of what we do when we travel. I'm a big one wheel fan and I'm a big Evolve skateboard fan. The Evolve GTR, I have had this every bit of, I wanna say 3 years. I have done absolutely no maintenance to this thing and it has treated me very, very well. I have the speed set at about 25 miles an hour. And with the all-terrain tires, I think you can get a little bit more than that. The acceleration for a skateboard is amazing. The range is typically 18 to 20 miles when I'm really just going at max speed, basically. Lower speeds, I get a little bit more, but I still haven't really crested that 22 to 23 mile range. This thing is so portable for the stability you get, for the range you get, for the speed you get. It makes it really easy to carry groceries, put a backpack on, grab a whole bunch of stuff and go, because it's easy to balance. If you're familiar with a skateboard or a snowboard, you'll pick it right up. The Evolve GTR Bamboo version is like 1400 bucks. They make a carbon one that's a little stiffer, a little less carvy. Same speed, same battery, all that kind of stuff, just a little bit different handling characteristics. On this particular board, all I've done is the Evolve lights because underglow is life. This thing has been dead reliable. I've done no maintenance, clean no bearings, clean no belts, and it's just never had an issue. I will say that on these, the remote is a little fragile. I had to put some tape around it because I dropped it and this button broke, but it is what it is. Apparently on the new Haydens, they fixed it. The next evolution for personal transport is the one wheels. So we are official one wheel dealers. These things are really, really useful because they're super small, especially if you have a lot of stuff in your van. They're easy to just kind of stuff away somewhere. If you have any kind of a decent power system, they're easy to charge. They pack away nicely. They're really easy to ride. They take a little bit more skill and finesse than the Evolve does. And you have to really maneuver at kind of lower speeds off-road, which is perfect for us in events where you have grass and gravel and all that kind of stuff. The one wheels have been absolutely amazing at being able to do that. This is the GT with the tread. This is the pint. So it basically goes from the cheapest to the most expensive. The big difference is being speed and range as well as the overall size. The pint's a little smaller. If you have really big feet, your feet are gonna kind of hang off of it. Whereas with the GT, you have more of your foot surface area on the pads. It handles a little bit differently. I find that the GT is much better if you're off-road a lot or if you're riding a little further distances, whereas the pint is really, really good if you're doing a lot more like city and need high mobility, stuff like that. And then going up from there is kind of the next evolution we had. We work with shock bikes down south in Florida and we got a Suron. So this is kind of, and has been for a while, the quintessential e-dirt bike, mountain bike, something or other, whatever you want to call it. They're faster than your typical e-bikes from Quiet Cat, from Specialized, Rad Bikes, all that kind of stuff. They're a lot more capable. They come with really good suspension, decent tires. This one is a new model. This is a 2023. This is the Light B. This one, we've clocked it at 50 miles an hour with my big self on it. So with something that's smaller, it'll go a little even faster. There's tons of upgrades. We're gonna end up doing a larger battery. The challenges of things like the Suron and the Zero, which we'll talk about here in a second, are carrying them. We use the 1UP heavy duty hitch rack. So we put it outside on the back. You also could put it inside the van if you wanted to. The beauty of electric is that you don't have all the nasty smells and all that kind of stuff. So really, really super flexible. You gotta check with your local laws if you're worried about that kind of stuff. Don't ride like an idiot and always wear protection when you're riding. The final kind of piece of the equation going from the smallest to the biggest is the Zero motorcycle. So they have a whole wide variety of them, anything from dirt bikes, kind of like this, but a little bit bigger, full-size dirt bikes, all the way up to street bikes like this. It's a 500-pound bike. It's pushing the limits of pretty much any hitch rack you're gonna do, but if you do the right mods, it should fit with no problem. We'll be taking this to a couple events this year. We'll be using our Victron energy system that we built in our Sprinter to charge the Zero on the road. But I just want to give you guys kind of a little look into what we use in our van travels to get around and do things. So look forward to telling you guys more about all of these. So keep an eye out as we go through each one in depth and kind of the pluses and minuses and all that kind of stuff to try and help you make a decision on your electrically effective mode of travel for your van. Nobody likes gas, nobody likes the smell of it. It's not that gas is bad, it's that it's hard to store things when they have smells and they take oils and all that kind of stuff inside the van. So for us, have a nice clean energy for transport is absolutely imperative when you're inside of a van and kind of traveling, if it works for your travel style. For us, it does. So thank you guys for hanging out with us. Again, I'm Grant with Free to Van Go. You can find us on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, all that kind of stuff. If you're already watching us, you know how to comment below. Don't forget to follow, like, and subscribe. If there's anything else you'd like to know, let us know. We're gonna get back on the road and get to work, and let us help you live life without limits.